The Holy Bible tells us, it gives us a test. How do we know a true prophet from a false prophet?
Greetings. Deedat asks, how can we know between a true and a false prophet? Deedat claims that the Bible gives us a test between true and false prophets.
First Epistle of John, chapter 4, verse 1, it says, Beloved, John is addressing, Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits whether they are of God. For many false prophets have gone out into the world. He says, believe not every spirit. Don't believe every Tom, Dick, and Harry, what he comes and tells you. Don't accept it.
Don't believe every Tom, Dick, and Harry. Don't accept it.
Believe not every spirit, but try the spirits whether they are of God. For many false prophets have gone out into the world.
But try or test the spirits whether they be of God.
The false prophet is a false spirit. The true prophet is a true spirit.
The following is a shameless plug. You can watch my video, which teaches in detail how Deedat wrongly mixes the words spirit and prophet.
The word prophet and spirit are used synonymously here.
Deedat says the words prophet and spirit are used synonymously here. In fact, they are not. But let us play along with Deedat's error for now.
Don't believe any spirit, but try them whether they are of God. For many false prophets have gone out into the world. How do you know a false prophet? He's got a false spirit.
Pay real close attention to what Deedat just said. How do you know a false prophet? He has got a false spirit.
How do you know a false prophet? He's got a false spirit.
Think about that. He has got a false spirit, not he is a false spirit. Notice Deedat does not remain consistent.
How do you know a false prophet? He's got a false spirit.
He has got a false spirit. He wants to say a false prophet is a false spirit. Then he says a false prophet has got a false spirit. If he's got a true spirit, he's a true prophet. You see, Deedat does not know the difference between being a spirit and having a spirit. That's his whole confusion. He is talking about things he simply knows nothing about.
How do you know a true prophet is with a true spirit? That's how you, if he's got the true spirit, he's a true prophet. He's got a false spirit, he's a false prophet. How do you know the true from the false? Verse 2. He says, the prophet that confesseth that Jesus is the Christ is of God.
The prophet that confesseth that Jesus is the Christ is of God. Notice at this point he has totally changed the text from the spirit that confesseth. He has just substituted prophet. But what does Christ mean? The high priest believed Christ would be the Son of God. Does Islam accept the accepted definition?
Your Bible, is it the spirit means the prophet that says?
Notice that Deedat continues to repeat his mistaken idea. You see, the spirit means the prophet that says.
He said, the spirit means the prophet that says.
He pauses, he stammers, he stutters, he has to replace the word. You see, the spirit means the prophet. Notice now that Deedat stops even including the actual text, which says spirit. He changes the text and corrupts the word of God to say prophet.
That Jesus is the Christ, he's come in the flesh, that he's born on earth, he is a true prophet. The prophet that confesseth that Jesus is the Christ is of God.
If that doesn't bother you people who call yourself Muslims, I don't know what does. Do you like it when somebody makes up words and puts them in the Quran? Do you? That's exactly what Deedat is doing here.
I said, why don't you apply this test to Muhammad?
Why don't you apply this test to Muhammad? And then he pauses to allow the audience to react. It swells, the applause. It sounds like an unanswerable taunt to the Christians. If you would just apply this one verse out of context to Muhammad, it will make you believe Muhammad is a prophet. Well, but we're not taught. Take verses out of context, change the words, and then apply them and put your heart and faith behind it. We're taught to put on the whole armor of God. We're taught to read the whole Word of God in context. Well, let's actually look at what the first epistle of John actually says. That means we have to look in context. 1 John 2:22. Who is the liar? It is the man who denies that Jesus is the Christ. 1 John 4:3. And every spirit, Deedat substitutes prophet here, that confesseth not that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh, is not of God. These verses look like they say about the same thing, right? But what does the context say? Who is the liar? It is the man who denies that Jesus is the Christ. Such a man is the Antichrist. He denies the Father and the Son. No one who denies the Son has the Father. Pay real close attention to this. No one who denies the Son has the Father. You see, Deedat confuses spirit and prophet. But they mean different things. The real synonyms here are Christ and Son, meaning Son of God. Notice in 1 John 2:22, who is the liar? It is the man who denies that Jesus is the Christ, denies the Father and the Son. Where is the parallel here? He who denies that Jesus is the Christ is denying that Jesus is the Son of God. So let's apply this to Muhammad. Does Muhammad say Jesus is the Son of God? Or does Muhammad deny God is a father and deny Jesus is his son? You know the answer. Muhammad denies the Son. Muhammad denies God is a Father and denies that God is the specific Father of Jesus. And who is it that the Word of God says denies the Son? The liar, the Antichrist, the false prophet. So why don't we apply this to Muhammad? In fact, we do. He, Muhammad, is a liar. He, Muhammad, is of the Antichrist. He, Muhammad, is a false prophet.
I said, why don't you apply this test to Muhammad?
We do.
Why don't you apply this test to Muhammad?
We do.
Why don't you apply this test to Muhammad?
We do. He denies the Father and the Son.
Why don't you apply this test to Muhammad?
We do. But those who follow Muhammad and obey Muhammad have been conditioned to reflexively take offense. Those who call themselves Muslim may be sincere in wanting to submit to God, but they follow a man who is a liar, a false prophet, and is anti-Christ in his message. He denies the Father and he denies the Son. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.